In this tutorial, we will show how to use the grouped FCS script for correlation measurements. So first we open the sample workspace and we select the file EBA488547 cross-linked PTU. We apply onto that file the grouped FCS script. So this file contains a FCS measurement of a DNA oligonucleotide labeled with two different fluorophores. One can be excited at 488, the other at 547 or 560 nanometers. And as they are bound to the same oligonucleotide, they should move in a coordinated fashion. So when the data is loaded into the SymphoTime and the script is applied on them, first of all, a window opens. And in this window, we have here the parameter area, the time trace, and here will the FCS code will be plotted. We want to calculate auto and cross correlation, so both. Here we have the channel selection, and we also can additionally adapt a time gate. If we click now onto calculate single, the FCS curves will be calculated. So once the calculation has finished, we will see the cross correlations and the autocorrelations appear in here. So the yellow and the red curve are the autocorrelations, and here you can see which curve is basically which. So the green curve is the cross correlation, and from the ratio of the amplitudes you can basically estimate, in this case, how good is the overlap between the red and the green volume. So we save these data and a new file is then generated with the results, and we will compare these data now with the results from another file. So we open another file again with the group FCS script. So this second file contains the same dyes, but now on two different oligonucleotides, so they are not cross-linked, they are moving in an uncoordinated fashion, and we expect in this case that the cross-correlation amplitude will be lower than in the file where we have just calculated the cross-correlation. So, as before, a window opens which contains the same areas, and again we select both to calculate auto and cross-correlation, and we adapt the time gate to basically the same settings as before, and again we calculate single. So once the data is calculated, the curves appear here in this panel, so we save the result and then we generate a result file. So now what I want to do is I want to compare two files and put them side by side so that you can see really the effect of the cross-correlation relative to the autocorrelations for a linked and the unlinked sample. So on the left I put the unlinked sample, on the right I put the sample where the two dyes are on the same oligonucleotide and therefore moving in a coordinated fashion. So if the area is a little bit small on the screen, then you can also just decrease the workspace area. So now you can see what is the use of the fluorescence cross correlation. So here in the unlinked sample, the cross correlation amplitude is much lower than here in the sample where they both are together.